Hello and welcome. We are going to start the process by creating an image based on information we have already created. And we're going to use Nano-Banana Pro in order to start the process. So we're going to go to gemini.google.com. We're then going to create an image. So what we're going to do now is we're going to upload a piece of information. Now that piece of information can be anything. It can be an article that you have the rights to use. It can be a transcript of something that you have already created. But we're going to use it in order to create an infographic image. So I'm going to upload here a transcript. So I've now uploaded the transcript. What I'm now going to do is I'm going to ask for a specific kind of image to be created here in Gemini. You can now decide on a specific kind of look and brand. I'm just going to write and ask Gemini to create an infographic image. Okay, so there's my prompt. What I'm going to now do, I'm going to make sure that image is checked. I'm going to make sure I'm in thinking mode and that I have the pro version. I'm now going to click enter and we're now going to await the image to be created. So Nano-Banana has now created the image. I'm going to click on it. And it does cover all of the points that I wanted to cover in the actual element. So I'm now going to add a transcript here in this area. I'm now going to turn on images. I'm going to use the very same prompt. I'm going to specify widescreen. And those are going to be all the parameters that I'm going to provide. I'm now going to click upload. I'm going to allow ChatGPT now to create the very same image. Okay, so here's the ChatGPT image. Obviously, I would have to iterate with this image and I would have to make sure that ChatGPT knew the exact size, but just as a basic prompt, this is what ChatGPT was able to do with the very same transcript and the very same prompt. Midjourney does not necessarily take documents and turn them into images, so we'll need to skip over Midjourney at this point. One application that I like a lot is SketchWow.ai. And what we're going to do is we're going to take that same transcript. We're going to put it inside of here. And this text box will hold the entire transcript for this short article. So I'm going to copy it. I'm going to place it inside of here. And what I'm going to ask for in this case is I'm going to ask for a visual summary. And I'm now going to click generate. And SketchWow has templates. And so we can choose any one of these templates that we think we'd want to use for the information that we have. And so it does a pretty good job of this process. And so what we would do here is we would then click edit. And what we would then do is we would then export this image. So we will then export the image. We'll export it as a PNG file. And for good measure, I like to save the SketchWow file. So I'm going to save this. Another application, it is a paid application that you can use in order to turn a document into a diagram or visual is Napkin.ai. So I'm going to sign into a paid account of Napkin.ai. I'm going to paste in that article. There's my article. And in Napkin, what I need to do is I need to highlight the entire thing. And then I need to click on this Thunderbolt to generate a visual. And what Napkin does, it interprets that information and it starts by creating a visual. And you can choose the format for the visual. And in this case, we can just say that we're going to choose a problem and solution. And we're going to choose that element. And we can then say we want this one. I'm just now going to download this image. And I'm going to download it as a PNG. Here's the SketchWow image, which I do like. Here's the ChatGPT image. Now, this would require some iteration with ChatGPT, but right out of the box, this is the ChatGPT image. This is the Nano-Banana image right out of the box. Now, one of the things that you're going to notice about the Nano-Banana image is it has citation reference numbers. And so you'd need to make sure that in your prompt that you tell it not to put those citation numbers in there and that you would not have that citation reference in there. But that is how it's going to come out. And of course, you're going to have the watermark at the bottom right hand corner. And then you also have a more minimalistic image. when you have Napkin.ai. Now again, with Napkin.ai, you're going to notice that the letters are handwritten, that there are only specific colors that are being used. You do have more options with Napkin to brand the colors and the look and feel of the images, and you can choose the one which works best for you. Thanks and have a great day.